Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Welcome to Mahdi English School. This is the class of Standard 1. We are going to learn mathematics. So, tell me, how do you feel? Happy? You all are learning? Very good. As you all know that FA4 exam is going to be started. So, from previous lecture, we have started a revision of FA4 exams, in which we have started revision of chapter number 9, time. So first, take a very short recap or revision of previous lecture and then we will move on to a new concept. I wake up at 8 o'clock. I go to school at 12 o'clock. I go to play at 6 o'clock. I go to bed at 10 o'clock. The bright shining sun indicates the day. The moon indicates the night. Day and night, morning and evening. What does it shows? With what it all the things are related? It is related with time. Revision chapter number 9, time. This is a clock which has numbers 1 to 12 on its face. These are the two hands of clock. What is a time? Time is defined as the duration in which all things happen, or a precise instant that something happens. An example of time is the Renaissance era. An example of time is breakfast at 8 o'clock in the morning, An example of time is a date at noon next Saturday. Tick the correct box. Now see. The girl is sleeping. Here we have two options. DAY, day. NIGHT, night. Now observe this image and think in your mind. Which time is this? Daytime or night time? Because most probably children used to sleep during the daytime also. Let me explain. Look at here. We can see the image of a moon. So we can say that this is night time. By observing the image, we find that this is a night time. Now see, the girl wearing a uniform, having a school bag, it seems that she says bye-bye to her mom. What time it is? We have two options, morning and evening. Think in your mind, is it morning time or evening time? I'm giving you some time so that you all can think about it. Either it is morning or evening. Let me explain. Here we can see a smiling sun hiding behind the clouds. So we can say that this is a morning time. In the early morning, the girl becomes ready to go at the school with a lovely, pretty, smiling face. Tick the activity that takes more time. Here you can see the boy is combing his hair. This boy is reading a book. Now tell me, which activity takes more time? We can see that the boy reading his book takes more time. Number the pictures in order of their happening. See, my dear students, here you can see the image of the same boy. But the activities are different. So we have to number the pictures in order of their happening. Now see, here the boy is thinking, is drawing, coloring, and suppose going to submit a picture to the teacher. Watch it carefully. Think in your mind, which action comes first? If I want to give number to this image, which will be the first? here the boy is thinking. So this comes first. Now there remains three more. Think in your mind which comes first. The boy is drawing an image. So we have to give number 2 that image. The boy is coloring. So it comes at third number. After finishing the painting, he is going to submit it to the teacher. It comes at fourth. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now let us see what time it is. The shorthand is at 1, longhand is at 12, the time is 1 o'clock. Shorthand is at 2, longhand is at 12, the time is 2 o'clock. Shorthand is at 3. Longhand is at 12. The time is 3 o'clock. Shorthand is at 4. Longhand is at 12. The time is 4 o'clock. Shorthand is at 5. Longhand is at 12. It is 5 o'clock. Shorthand is at 6, longhand is at 12, it is 6 o'clock. The shorthand is at 7, longhand is at 12, the time is 7 o'clock. The shorthand is at 8. Longhand is at 12. So the time is 8 o'clock. Shorthand is at 9. Longhand is at 12. The time is 9 o'clock. Shorthand is at 10, longhand is at 12, the time is 10 o'clock. Shorthand is at 11. Longhand is at 12. So the time is 11 o'clock. Shorthand and long hand both are at 12. The time is 12 o'clock. This has been taken from Anshum's class timetable. Write the time in the two ways to complete the puzzle. Now we are going to see the timetable of Anjum. And there we have only clocks which shows some time. We have to find out what time is it and we have to write the time as per we see in that clock. Maths period or maths lecture is right now we are having maths lecture. Am I right? So now see, here we have the clock. We can see that shorthand is at 9 and long hand is at 12. So what time it is? Shorthand indicates the hour or what time it is. So, as here the shorthand is at 9, we can say that it is 9 o'clock or 9. Understand everyone? C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R, computer period or computer lecture. Now, Anjum's computer lecture is going to be started. Now tell me, you all comes in first standard and now you all are having computer lecture. So tell me, you all are enjoying? You all know the advantages of computer as well as disadvantages of computer. In this pandemic, some of the students get studies through the medium of computer or laptop. So now computer lecture is going to be started. See what time is it indicates. You can see the clock which has numbers 1 to 12 on its face. Here, shorthand is at 11. Longhand is at 12. So, what time it is? It is 11, 2 dots and 0, 0. Everyone, write the time 11, 2 dots, 0, 0. Or 11 o'clock. Games period. Your favorite lecture, huh? You all likes to play the games. Which type of games? Football, volleyball, cricket, handball. So you might be familiar that there are indoor and outdoor games. Do you know the difference of indoor and outdoor games? We will discuss this afterwards. Now let's move to the topic. Games period is going to started. Whose timetable is this? This is Anjum's timetable. So her games period is going to started. See what time it is. You can see a clock here. And now you all know that the clock has numbers 1 to 12 on its face. In this clock, you can see that the short hand is at 2. The long hand is at 12. So, it is 2 o'clock. We can write the time on this way also. 2, then make 2 dots and 0, 0. You can see the time written on this way in digital clock or digital watch. Do you know the difference of clock and watch? Okay, let me explain the clock. You can see it at your home on the wall. And the watch, the small watch, which you all used to wear it in your hand. It is called watch. And the clock you see on the wall of your at home or at school or any hospital, wherever. It is called a clock, wall clock. So now let's write the time on the another way. 2 o'clock. So my dear students, today we learn how to write the time. Now it's time to make revision of tables. You all are ready. Now you all have to write with me. Write the tables properly with a very good handwriting. Leave one line after completing one line. Okay. As table of 6, 7 and 8 included in our FFO syllabus. So we are going to make revision for the same. Table of 6. Six ones are 6. Six twos are 12. Six threes are 18. Six fours are 24. Six fives are 30. Six, six are 36. Six, sevens are 42. Six, eights are 48. Six nines are 54. Six tens are 60. So everyone, have you completed table of 6? Have you written it properly? Very good. Now, table of 7. Write the heading. Write the heading with a very good handwriting. Seven ones are seven. Seven twos are 14. Seven threes are 21. Seven fours are 28. Seven fives are 35. Seven six are 42. Seven sevens are 49. Seven eights are 56. Seven nines are 63. Seven tens are 70. Table of 8. Eight ones are 8. Eight twos are 16. Eight threes are 24. Eight fours are 32. Eight fives are 40. Eight sixes are 48. Eight sevens are 56. Eight eights are 64. Eight nines are 72. Eight tens are 80. So, my dear students, have you completed the tables? Very good. At your home, everyone. Stay safe. Stay happy. Take care of yourself. We will meet in the next lecture. Till then, thank you very much and bye-bye everyone.